They say you can't do gaming on Java, folks. Let me surprise you.
I want to mention that this review is mostly based on the information provided by Bombi Games. I recommend you to check the website, as it has more information about the games I provided here, including game credits. I'll leave a link in the description. It all started with 2004. 2004 Real Football, or soccer, depending on the country you live in, has three basic controls. Three buttons, with which you perform a short pass, a long pass, and a shot, or a tackle if you're defending, and with the other buttons, you move on the field. Unlike future games, this title is fully licensed, and each player has a personalized stat. You get only three game modes, Exhibition, International Cup, and European Cup, which, even if they don't sound like much, remember that this game came out in 2004. At that time, you were happy that your phone could run Snake. This game was a beast, when you judge it in context. 2005 Real Soccer, or football depending on the country, brings many new improvements. Like for example now, you get a training mode. And there are more clubs, such as Liverpool or AC Milan. But during gameplay, you get a power bar, which is useful. And now, players can do tricks like crosses. Also, by double tapping a key, the player can sprint. And during matches, occasionally, there is a minigame where you have to guide an exhibitionist to not get caught by the guards that chase after him. Now, this is a feature I love in a football game. 10 out of 10. The game is going 100 miles per hour in the right direction. 2006 brings new game modes. Aside of the standard friendly league and cup modes and training mode, there is now a penalty kick mode. There is also a Go for 2006 mode, where you have to qualify for the World Cup in Germany. The game totally contains 48 national teams, 16 of these are unlockable. You also get 16 club teams, and in addition to those, you also get 7 all-star teams, which you can also unlock. The game uses the FIFA Pro license, and it contains 1000 real-life players. And another nice new addition are the replays. Also, 2006, like others from now on, have a 3D version, and unlike other Java games where 3D meant good graphics but poor content, here you get the best of both worlds. You have awesome 3D graphics and the same huge amount of content from the 2D version. Real Soccer 2007 carries the FIFA Pro license too, which means that it features real-life players but doesn't have any real team or competition names. The game modes include friendlies, cups, leagues, penalty kicks, and training. There are three different leagues and three different cups, including an international cup based on the 2006 World Cup. The controls are a little bit smoother, and the game was just amazing to have back in the day. Real Football 2008 has everything 2007 had, plus some new features, the new Road to 2008 and Challenge Modes. Road to 2008 involves qualifying for and competing in the Euro 2008, while the Challenge Mode is made up of a number of real-life football scenarios, where you have to complete objectives. The 2009 edition of Real Football is now finally fully licensed, just like FIFA and PES, and contains over 200 clubs and national teams, as well as licensed stadiums such as those from Milan, Manchester, or Madrid. The different game modes include training, a challenge mode where historic matches can be replayed, friendly games, cups, leagues, and penalty kicks, so you get all the game modes from the previous games. The game supports multiplayer over Bluetooth, and back in the day you could also join the RF League, an online league with 130 teams, where other players can be challenged. Scores are stored through an online leaderboard accessible through WAP. This depends on the capabilities of the handset, however. But it was cool. I mean, you had a full-fledged FIFA game. You had everything a full-fledged FIFA on a console could do, but translated on a Java phone. Real Football 2010 includes most of the content of previous releases. The gameplay works the same as before and has the same controls, with the same moves being possible to do. This includes performing lobs, flip-flap tricks, and one-two passing. There are also two new game modes, Enter the Legend and Clubmaster. Enter the Legend involves playing a league in a season as a single player, while Clubmaster is a simplified management mode where it is possible to buy or sell players in addition to playing the matches. And there is also an editor, which can be used to swap players between teams and change team and player names. And the loading screens have trivia. Real Football 2011 brings new graphics. The rest of the gameplay is the same. I'm going to list the game modes though, so that you can have an idea of how dense the game still is. So you get Career, which is called Enter the Legend and Clubmaster. You get World Tour, Cup, League, Challenge Mode, you get Multiplayer, Training, and Penalty Kicks. It also includes the 2010 Intel Cup competition, which is based on the World Cup, and is possible to play with or without the qualifying rounds. The Editor and RF League are also still in the game. Starting from Real Football 2012, there is another major split in versions. If before we had the 2D version and the 3D version, now the split is between the portrait mode versions for phones with buttons and the landscape versions for higher-end phones. Both versions offer the same content. What is impressive is that this game finally includes licensing again. The game has licensed content and contains over 240 teams, both national teams and clubs from leagues, with the players' real names. The main game modes are Friendly Games, the 2012 European Cup, the Qualifier as well as the actual Cup, and the RF League. Other game modes are Club Master, where you start with a team in a low division cup. You get the Cup game mode, where you play an International Cup, European Cup or a Club Cup. You have the Enter the Legend mode, where you focus on a single player and become one of the best in the world. You get Historical Challenges, where you replay 20 historical and iconic matches. You get League, where you play an entire season as a club or a national team. You get Penalty Kicks, which you know what they do. And you get Training and World Tour, where you play against the best team around the world. With these modes, the game sums up every good feature the franchise brought along these years, making it a love letter to all real soccer fans out there, and also making it the best game out of this list. Real Football 2013 is mainly similar to 2012, only that now it has an annoying new feature. Its main new feature is that you can collect cards. This uses an in-game currency system. You can earn cash by winning matches or competition or passing trainings or history challenges. Basically, by playing the game, you earn cash. The cash is then spent on lottery tickets, where you draw packs of cards. Collected cards can be used as boosts in the game or to unlock content such as new leagues and game modes. And the game modes included in this version are the same as in the previous game, which makes the game annoying since you have to unlock stuff that was previously free. Real Football 2014 removes the annoying lottery system from the previous game and adds the Skill Lab game mode. Here you play minigame challenges in 5 categories: dribble, penalty, free kick, hit the crossbar, and scoring drill. In each of these, there are 50 levels and you can earn up to 3 stars in each depending on your performance. You can also be awarded RF points, with which you can unlock special features such as teams, items, or game modes. Yes, you don't have everything unlocked from the beginning, like in previous games. And this game returns the tradition of made-up names. It doesn't have licensing anymore. Real Football 2015 is almost a copy of the previous game, only that now you get less. The challenge mode is missing. Real Football 2016 is again a copy of 2015, which was already a copy of 2014. Real Football 2017 is disappointing. It has less content than Real Football 2016, which already had cut content. Also, it doesn't add anything notable new features. You still get a solid handful of game modes though, which include friendlies, the season management mode, local penalties, 4 different cups, including World Cup 2014, and 9 leagues, as well as a training mode. The only addition is that there are daily missions where you can earn RF points. The points can be used to unlock extra content such as new teams. And Real Football 2017, just like the last few games in this series, doesn't have licensing. Real Football 2018 is very similar to 2017, only that it has an addition. It has the addition of a 5v5 mode, which is a simplified version of the same mode you get on Android. The main difference is that it's not played online, and instead is played against AI opponents. So the 5v5 isn't online, it's a single player. Also, the wiki article says that you are always the attacker in this mode, and you are never defending. Real Football Manager Edition 2007 features the two top leagues from 5 European countries: England, Italy, Spain, France, and Germany. There are real players, but no real team names. So, for example, Arsenal is called London, and Manchester United is simply Man Red. There are about 4,000 players, each with individual stats in 14 categories. The game has a lot of content. And similar to other football management games, you control of picking a team and tactics, designing the training plan, buying and selling players, as well as hiring coaches and scouts. Tactics can be set for both the team as a whole, as well as for individual players. The game uses the isometric Real Football Match engine, which allows you to watch the full 90 minutes of a game. And it's also possible to change to an overhead view, or a stat display view, during the game. Real Football Manager Edition 2009 is as solid as the previous game, only that now it has a new option, the option to skip matches, one half at a time. The game also has an option to export teams to Real Football 2009, which is also cool, and it's still as solid as the first game. Real Football Manager Edition 2010 has mostly the same content as the previous games, but the teams and players have been updated to the 2009 and 2010 season. 3 new leagues have been added to the game: the Premier Division of Portugal, Argentina, and Brazil. Like before, the game uses licensed players, but all teams have geographic names, which means that the teams have made up names. Also, it seems that you can change the camera angle in the game, which means that you can see the players play only while in this view. You can't, like in the other game, view it like a normal broadcast. Real Football 2013 contains 13 leagues, the same as in the previous game. Top 2 from England, Italy, Spain, Germany, and France, as well as the Premier Division of Portugal, Argentina, and Brazil. The game has largely the same features as the other games, but it also has a new addition. It has a mall, where you can buy various items that affect the team in various ways. This includes clearing red and yellow cards, healing players, increasing the abilities of the team or of a player, and the morale or energy. The items are bought with the game's in-game currency, which is called manager credits. They are then added to the manager's bag and can be used ahead of a match. And this is it with the list. I hope you liked it. As I said, most of the information in this video is this time from Moby Games. I suggest you check out their site. It's really detailed, and if you're into Java games, I recommend you the website. If you liked the video, please hit the like button and subscribe. If you want to support me in my pursuit to review as many video games as possible, you can do that on Patreon or on the channel's membership section. You would help me a lot if you would. If you want, you can follow me on Twitch, Instagram, or Discord. And if you want to see another video of mine, just wait till I stop talking and there will be thumbnails of other videos I've made. Thanks for watching.